A national gun registry is the first step towards gun confiscation. And we've seen gun confiscation recently in Australia, and we all know how that's going now. Confiscation is the anti-gunner's goal here. Don't ever pretend it's not. Hey everybody, it's Phil with the Minuteman Moment. If you don't already know, not only are all of our Minuteman videos on YouTube, but they're also on the Warrior Poet Society Network, which I think is pretty cool. So if you want to watch our stuff on a platform that respects you and American culture, head on over there to see what's happening. But before you do, please like this video and let me know what you think about Biden's national gun registry. Speaking of which, back to that now. GOA knows that creating a registry of all guns in this country is illegal, but that's not gonna stop Biden and the permanent bureaucracy in Washington from trying to make that happen anyway. According to an internal ATF document obtained by the Gun Owners of America, the Biden administration in just the last year processed the names of more than 54 million US gun owners. That's outrageous. That is an outrageous number of records. But that's legal, believe it or not. It's time for that law to go, but that's a different story. But it doesn't end there, because according to our information, the ATF is considering more regulatory changes to get the government a master list of every gun-owning American who's purchased a firearm through a gun store. And I'll break that down for you now. The 1968 Gun Control Act says the records of out-of-business gun stores get sent to the ATF, but the law says nothing about using those records to create a national gun registry. Oh, and by the way, if you didn't know, the floor at the building in West Virginia where all these records are sent actually caved in because there were so many records being stored there. The ATF doesn't really care about the legality or illegality because they have this dubious authority to write regulations about the implementation of laws. And I'm saying dubious because their regulatory authority only exists to help them implement the laws exactly as Congress wrote them. Not that it matters much to any of us, since all gun laws are unconstitutional anyway. But do you remember the Biden ghost gun ban? That's the one where we found that my Glock 40 could be regulated with up to 16 background checks. Well, if you remember that video, you might also remember our video where we explained how that same proposed rule is helping the Biden administration institute a gun registry. According to current law, FFLs have the option of destroying records older than 20 years. If a gun store goes out of business, that means they only have to turn over the last 20 years of records to the ATF. Under those rules alone, the ATF has amassed 54 million records to put in their registry last year alone. And this has been going on for many years now. But with Biden's proposed rules, FFLs would no longer be able to destroy those records after 20 years. That means FFLs would have to keep 100% of their firearm transaction records forever, or at least until they go out of business, at which point they end up in Biden's registry in the building in West Virginia with the caved-in floor. I'll say it again. Lists, registries, whatever you call them, are the first steps a government needs to facilitate gun confiscation. What's worse is that some people are actually advocating that these records be digitized and use those files for a gun registry. I wonder why. When asked to comment on these stored records, the ATF said those out-of-business records do not constitute an initiation or continuation of any federal gun registry. Yeah. Check out the article on our leak in the Washington Free Beacon for a little background on that governing law, and I'll drop a link in the description below. So here's what all of you can do. We always need you to contact your representative. It works. I've seen it work. Just a couple of weeks ago, you guys flamed those congressmen who voted for red flag gun confiscation in the National Defense Authorization Act. They knew they messed up because you brought the heat. But this time, we want to make noise a little bit differently. In the description is a link to the article on the leak we obtained. Copy that link and post it to one or all of your social media accounts with the hashtag #NoGunRegistry. And the handle of your congressman and both senators. We're also gonna have a link in the description below to help you find your senators and congressmen. We'll see you soon.